Beloved members of the fraternity of the custodian of the Holy Land, of St. Francis, dear Father, Christ is risen. Christos Anesti. It is with great joy that we greet you in this bright feast of the Paschal Feast, in which we enjoy the happy event of being able to celebrate Easter on the same day. Our visit to you now, after your visit was earlier today, is no casual formality. Rather, these visits are a part of our moral, spiritual, and familial obligation to each other in our homes. We say this because our life here in Jerusalem is the life of a family. So, like families, we can visit each other on special occasions, even on the same day and the same hour. So, as a family, we can proclaim the resurrection together with one voice and say with a full heart together the words of one of the ancient hymns of the Western Church. Christ, the victim undefiled, man to God has reconciled, whilst in strange and awful strife met together death and life. Christians, on this happy day, haste with joy your vows to pay. Christ is risen. Today we cry, now he lives no more to die. I think you are familiar with this.
Yes.
We celebrate Easter this year in the warm remembrance of the rededication of the sacred edicule, where the mystery of our Easter faith finds its focus. And we wish to take this festive occasion to express once again our gratitude to you, personally, your fraternity, and to the Brotherhood, and to your community for the full and enthusiastic cooperation that you have given to this work. You have borne even the inconvenience of the displacement of your space in the Holy Edicule with patience and generosity. We mean the galleries that you have availed to us. The entire process of the exploration and renovation of the EDU has received worldwide attention. Not only has there been interest in the structure itself, as well as the remains of the cave that it encloses. The eyes of the world have also been attentive to the fresh experience of cooperation between our three communities in the carrying out of this work. This is the great hope that has arisen from this joint project. Needless to say, just as we are, the world is looking forward to the completion of the renovation of the remaining parts of the compound of the Holy Sepulchre, including the underground sewer system and the floor of the rotunda. We celebrate the Easter feast once again at a time when there is much difficulty and danger in our world, especially in our region. Syria is of special concern to us these days, as is Egypt. Faithful people are suffering persecution, millions remain displaced from their ancestral homes, and there is an instability on the world stage that creates great uncertainty. In these times, it is all the more incumbent upon us, to whom divine providence has entrusted the diaconia of the Holy Land and our sacred shrines, to show to the world that the truth and power of the resurrection to bring new and more abundant life. This mission begins as leaders, as well as the communities we lead, take responsibility for our common life. We give thanks to Almighty God that we have been given this opportunity to deepen our cooperation in the spiritual mission of the holy places. May the light of the resurrection sustain you, your paternity, the Brotherhood of St. Francis, and the communities that you serve throughout our beloved Holy Land. And may the risen Lord crown our joint effort as an encouragement to all those who look to Jerusalem for the strengthening of their faith in the living God who raised our Lord Jesus Christ from the dead. Christ is risen. Christos Anesti.
Your Beatitude, Patriarch Theophilos, Your Excellencies, and dear brothers of the Greek Orthodox Patriarchate, it is a great joy for us to welcome you and share with you the Eastern greetings. Maybe we will have more and more occasion to meet in this way. We rejoice with you on these feast days because these are the most important days for our spiritual life, the days in which the good news of resurrection resounds all around the world, beginning from Jerusalem. Every day in the Holy Sepulchre, we contemplate the physical place that preserves the memory of the burial of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the physical location where the body of our Savior did not see corruption and death was defeated. Precisely because it is the place of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, it is also the basis of our faith and our Christian hope and also of our unity. Here in the Holy Land and in all the Middle East, all we Christians are a minority, and we know how our brothers and sisters in Christ are still suffering. I think particularly to our brothers in Egypt, but also to our brothers in Syria, in Iraq, and also here in some way. Sometimes it seems that Good Friday is far away from the morning of Easter and Resurrection, but precisely in this context it is very important that we strengthen our conscience of being one body in Christ. It is very important in this context that we strengthen our cooperation and our common witness to the power of death and resurrection of Christ. That is the unarmed power of love that goes up to the gift of one's life. During the works for the restoration of the Holy Edicol, we experienced how important it is to cooperate, and we experienced also that the entire world is looking at us and expecting that we become a sign of fraternity in the name of faith, in a world in which, unfortunately, The differences of faith are often source of hostility, hate, and even death. On this occasion, I would like to express feelings of gratitude for the fraternal relationship that permitted us to cooperate, particularly in the restoration of the Holy Edicule here in Jerusalem. And we also agree that it is very important to prosecute, to follow the other steps. I think that it is our duty to increase in fraternal relations between us and between our communities in an atmosphere of mutual trust and cooperation. Our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us according to the scriptures and is risen for us from the dead on the third day, around his holy sepulchre, around the place of his resurrection, has made us regain a greater closeness as true brothers. This fraternal relation and cooperation is simply necessary if we won't carry on the rites for the benefit and the protection of the Christian community and of the holy places. We pray that our common witness of our Lord Jesus Christ, risen from death and only Savior of the world, will continue to improve day by day by the grace of the Holy Spirit, that is the first gift of the risen Christ in the evening of the original Easter. With these feelings, I want to say thank you for your fraternal visit and wish you a Holy Easter. Christos Anesti.
Jesu tibi sit gloria.